Hello, hello! Welcome back to the Stay Fitness channel. If you're new to this channel, my name is Daniela. I'm a fitness, nutrition and life coach specializing in obesity and diabetes management. So today's video is another idea where you could make around the Christmas period, around the festive period. So I've been looking around to find things that are animal-based, as close as like carnivore as possible. But they're still scrumptious, delicious, indulgent, and most of all, it's something that you can propose to your whole family, to your friends and all that, and no one's gonna say, oh, this doesn't taste like the real deal or anything like that. Because we know when we tell people something's low carb keto, they're like, or if you tell them it's 100% carnivore, then not even. But yeah, this recipe I found it on the YouTube channel Keto Twins, which they need no introduction. You obviously know them. They are so funny, so sweet, and they made this recipe which they got the inspiration from one of my favorite all-time programs, which is Diners, Drivers and Dives. Dines? Yeah, I haven't watched it in 10 years. I don't know, not 10 years. I used to watch it a lot when I didn't have Netflix, I didn't have any of that, I just had cable TV in London when I was renting like a room or something like that. So the Dinners, Drivers and Dines, that was like on repeat on Food Network with Guy Fieri. And it was like, I love it. I don't know why I love watching like him going to like these American diners and trying this amazing food that I never saw in my entire life. So the Keto Twins saw an episode where they like deep fried a whole chicken cutlet and then they made it into a parmigiana. No, because in Italy parmigiana is like another dish, it's like the aubergine thing. So like this whole parmesan, I don't even know how to say it, is not Italian, it's like a American recipe. So it's basically a chicken cutlet with tomato and then cheese on top, and usually serve over like pasta or something like that. So they wanted to try that, making like a carnivore based pizza. It seemed delicious. I thought I'd propose it for you for like as a like a party food, maybe a little bit smaller, but as a, like it, this recipe is so great because you can like cook, make in stages as when you like have time, and it can be there ready for you, so you don't have to stress making everything at once, long preps or anything like that. So this recipe is like, if you, well, I'll tell you how to make it carnivore. This, I made it like kind of ketovore. But yeah, let's have a look at how to make this chicken parmesan crust pizza carnivore thing. So what you're going to need is like a pack, 500 grams of chicken mince. You're going to add one egg to it and some salt. You can now go crazy with the spices, onion powder, garlic powder, oregano, Italian seasoning, do whatever you want essentially with it. I just kept it really simple because I think like then you're going to add cheese and you can add some toppings, so that's I think enough. Then basically what you're going to do is make some patties. And you make them as big, as small, as thin, as thick as you want. I think as thin as possible is better, so it's going to resemble more like a mini pizza. And put them between two pieces of parchment paper, and then you're going to freeze it until solid, and then you're going to bread it. So my breading is made of leftover low-carb breads, from protein sparing to anything like that. I just put it in the oven, dry it, and then blitz it up until fine powder. You can also add some pork rinds, parmesan cheese to the coating, anything like that, some extra seasoning. And so you're going to so you can either choose, I do it like egg and just pork rind, just the breading, or you can do double breading. You can add some almond flour in the mix if you want. I just did once and I think that's more than enough. And then you're going to refreeze it. Again, all stages, like you can keep the frozen patties in the freezer for a week or two before you're ready to bread them. Then once they're breaded, you can again leave them for a week or two like that until you're ready to fry them. Then you're going to deep fry them. I deep fry them into lard. And so I have this like thermometer telling me the temperature of the oil, which I think is really handy, making sure it doesn't get too hot or too cold. I then fry them until like nice golden brown. And again, once you fried all of your patties, so you can either, once they're breaded in the freezer, fry a few or put them in the air fryer until golden and then eat them there and then. You can cook them all and then keep them to the side for when you're ready to serve. So you have options, and then once you're ready to serve, you're going to put some tomato sauce on top, your favorite low carb tomato sauce, some cheese. I choose like a simple margherita with like basil, but you can do pepperoni, you can do anything you want, and then you're going to just broil it until the cheese is melted, essentially, which as I said, this recipe can be done in stages. You can get some help, someone help you making all the patties, fry them in batches and all that, so like you don't get to the day of your party, Christmas day or whatever, having like a million things to do. And I mean, look at them, they look so delicious. No one's gonna say, what is this? Why is it no full carb or anything like that? And they are as delicious as they look, but don't take my word for it. I'm going to taste it on camera so you see. Here it is. I mean, the smell of basil, it's so nice. I haven't actually had any basil in so long, so I love it. percent a winner, because it doesn't taste anything like pizza, like the bread in like, what does have to do with pizza, but it's crispy, it's tasty. It's everything you want in a like a party food or like a snack or something like that. It's like crispy, got melted cheese, it's tasty. Of course you can you can adjust the salt as you want. Like I didn't make it overly salty because I don't like it. But yeah, 100% a winner. Is going to like, everyone's gonna go for it. No one's gonna be like, what is this low carb stuff that you're trying to make me eat or anything like that. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you Keto Twins for trying this recipe out. If you did enjoy, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family. Let me know in the comments below your favorite party food, how you're going to try like your favorite animal-based kind of party food that you're maybe gonna try this Christmas. But yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.